guy, and I'm the ass.
Before too long, I came up with a title because basically it was taking so long to do, and we're not getting any younger. You name it.
Yeah, who's not on it? D12 are on it. They featured in two songs.
Sandy Tong, of course. There's a couple more R&B singers actually up and coming. Young Nate, Daniel DeBerg,
Nazareth.
Nazareth, 70s
Scottish rock band Nazareth.
The album's sort of got three types of songs to it. There's a dance phase of the album, there's also rock and R&B.
It's going to be something that you'll like on it.
We're kind of trying to find ourselves with this album rather than in just doing one sort of specific.
Yeah, I guess boring too quick, Danger Zone, basically, it's the first song on the album for a reason, because it's a sort of in-your-face standout track, which is basically about us being sleazes, basically. If you're out with your girlfriend, just make sure you keep a tight hold of her in case one of us tries sleazing about her. Well, the older Danger Zone is...
It's like a zone around you. So the song, the concept is, i.e. like,
don't let us
when a female enters the zone.
Yeah, it's the rules, yeah. This is the only song we actually wrote together. We actually sat down and actually wrote together, believe it or not.
We normally do it versus...
Yeah, in our own room. In our own space, because when I'm writing music, I can't have folks speaking to me. I can't have my computer on, my TV on. I've got to have silence and just me and the music.
The headphones, yeah.
Which sounds really cheesy and over the top, but that's how it works. Mm-hmm. But this song, I just sat down and wrote it. It's not a real situation, but basically, it's not something that's happened to us anyway. But it's about finding out your girlfriend's been cheating on you.
So we're the same person.
Yeah.
In the song.
Yeah, well, I'm your conscience.
Yeah, I'm the actual person getting cheated on.
And I'm the voice in his head telling him, look, you're getting cheated on.
Hey, yo, what's up, man? It's Bizarre from B12. Want to get a shout out to Shy and BRF.
Out of My Face was produced by a house producer, Chino Dino, that we've been working with as well. He's from Puerto Rico. He's amazing. He's a dubstep house.
Everything, yeah. Yeah, okay,
Bizarre. That features Bizarre from D12 as well. That was one of the last songs we did in the album, actually. Sent Bizarre the song and the beat, and he loved it.
It's a party track, really housey, kind of dancey feel to it. And it's just a song that you want to get smashed to, basically, is it?
Yeah.
You hear it, you sort of go out and have drinks and lose the plot of it. Get over me, claim me, and want a piece of this, bite me. My personal favourite song of the whole album. It's different to anything else on the album. It's basically, it's a collaboration with Nazareth, 70s rock act, who are also Scottish as well. You'll probably hear them. And it's basically about saying to yourself, okay, I've got enough love now. In this race for love, I'm on the starting line. A mountain's only worth climbing if it's hard to climb. Your love hurts, but it's worth it if it's hard to find. Yeah, there's a video for that as well. Went down south to Newcastle and Southampton to do a video for that earlier this year. And it's just got finished and the final edit's amazing, isn't it? Taste the pain, I can face
the rain. Never got the sunshine to replace the rain. I've got enough. Yeah, right. Track number 7 is Rockstar,
which features Kaniva of from D12, Eminence band D12. And basically, it's a song, it's just our way of saying we're like, we've got the Rockstar attitude, if you know what I mean. We're like, even though we don't play instruments or nothing like that, or we're proper rock without guitars or drums or nothing, we're still...
Yeah, what's the line in the chorus?
I don't play drums, I don't play the guitar. I just play girls because I'm a mother rock star. Don't trust me, I'll break your heart, girl, trust me. It's Troublesome, which is the latest song that we've done in the album.
That's my personal favourite.
Yeah, that's personal favourite. That was a sort of last minute kind of song, and it turned out one of the best ones, I think, in the album. Basically, I wrote it because I think girls, they always say, oh, they want a nice guy to look after them and keep them safe and warm, but nah, deep down they want a bad guy to keep them running and keep them on their toes.
Absolutely.
We're not exactly selling ourselves well. We'll cheat on you and we'll treat you like basically.